Fewer people on board lorries are getting injured in road traffic accidents, with figures hitting a 10-year low last year. That's according to the traffic police. It comes as two recent accidents involving lorries that are under investigation have raised safety concerns. Nia Rongwei has more.
Lorries like these ferry large groups of workers without seat belts between their dormitories and work sites. But two deaths last month have put the spotlight on such practices, placing pressure on firms to protect their workers. One private hire bus operator has been getting more inquiries from companies that want to switch from lorries to buses, which are perceived to be safer.
From the past 2 weeks, we are seeing from one to now, maybe this week we receive about four. If the demand does increase, we definitely will look into the investment of getting more of these smaller buses.
Injuries from lorry-related accidents have been falling since safety measures like installing higher railings and canopies were put in place a decade ago. About four people per thousand lorries were hurt last year, as traffic volumes dipped during the pandemic, though the number of deaths have crept up since 2018. One firm says it's hard to stop the use of lorries completely.
If you transport a group of workers from a point A to point B in a big group, then perhaps maybe a bus is a better way to do it. If you have equipment with a material, how are you going to bring your material, your equipment in a bus?
But these practices can be dangerous, according to one non-profit organization, which says it's been in talks with the authorities to enhance worker safety.
At the end of the day, you know, I think installing seatbelts, I think is mandatory, whether that's done in, you know, in the lorries themselves or in some other kind of vehicle. We can move towards that goal in stages, but there needs to be a clear line of sight of how and when we get to that goal.
MPs are expected to raise the issue of lorry safety when Parliament sits next week.